Hi, welcome to a PHP tutorial from StartPHP. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can set up the PHPMaker such that the username and password for your database will work also for local and set it automatically for different password and username for your web hosting. Let's get started with this. We all know that when you connect to your local host, well, for local host, for example, in this case, the username is root and I have no password, and it gets connected. If I select refresh, as you can see, the database has not been altered, so which means it is connecting without any issue. But once you upload it to your actual web hosting, you will get error. And here, once you upload it without updating the password, usually you will get this error. It's or you have to do a lot of manual alteration so it will work. I'm going to show you how you can do this. So all the time, if you make any changes, it will be automatically reflected on the file that you have, so you would not worry. This is the project. I have only one table, it's called items, and I have one item here. Item ID is one, this is a title, description, and date, nothing else. I'm not gonna make it complicated, but it is local, as you can see. And here, once you upload it without updating the password, usually you will get this error. It says root at localhost using no password error. So fail to connect to the database. It's called DB password, database password, and I have only one table which has this text. If I click edit, we will be able to see it. So this is on localhost here. If you see the URL here, it says localhost. To make changes, you need to go to get the IP address for your server, run this code. I will provide you also this one. This is a variable from PHP. This is a server variable, and it says server underscore ADDR address. When you run it locally, this is what you get, 127.0.0.1. And once you upload it to your server, to your website, and here on startphp.com/server.php, this is a different IP address. So we can use this to identify your local and remote machine and assign different username and password for the database. On your PHPMaker, click on your project and click on one of the tables. Click on items and you will see fields, table, and code, server event. Click on that, and you will see a lot of different options. If I've collapsed so many of these, in your case it might be long, but under the global and all pages, and here this is for all pages. As you can see here, this looks bold, database connecting and then user ID loading. This shows bold because I've changed it. Look at the lower one. If I press enter here and then exit, you will see now this is bold. So this will also help you that you know which one you have updated. Now we go to the database connection here, and this is where we need to make some changes. And here we are inserting the information that were already there. I have prepared it. And this is the inside the function. We are just putting all these values. This is already built in. So let me explain it what it does. This info is an array that is holding inside this array. We have host, we have user, password, and database name. And this ampersand in front of it, it means pass by reference, meaning we are able to change it inside this function. So we are changing these values, but we have a condition here. It says current user IP, if it is not equal to 127.0.0.1. In your local machine, the IP address that you're running will, most of the time, unless you change it, is 127.0.1. If it is different, then I'm gonna show you to change it. So on your web hosting, it is never 127.0.1 for actual domains. So you should have non-local IP address. Now, what it does, it checks, it gets the IP and it checks it. If it is not equal to that, then we will update it by providing the host name, by providing the user name, by providing the password and the database name. So you can have a different database, different username, different password for your remote. And if it is not true, then the password and username that the username and password that you have entered here, it will work for you. I'll provide you this code after preparing it with a username, password, and all these four information here. Then copy this and come to the PHPMaker and paste it in here. And after that, save it and generate. I'm generating it. This has been generated, and the file that is being uploaded, updated, is this file. This is the DB password. This is the whole project, and the last file here, it says user fn.php. It is this file, user fn.php, user function. Generating the file, if we go here and check user fn.php and open it, and you will see the function that we have inserted is inside this user fn.php in here. I've already uploaded the project. I just need to upload this one file, user fn.php. I'm using FileZilla. I'm just dragging and dropping it. Or if you want, just right click and upload, it will be uploaded. Here is the local project. If I refresh it, you see it is working. There is no issue. And let me go to the remote, which had error. Now let's refresh it and see. Now that error is gone, and we get all these error because the table doesn't exist inside the StartPHP dot items. Item is a table that does not exist, and I've not copied it. So let me go for let me go to my local database, phpMyAdmin, and this is the table that I want. So click on it and then export. I'm exporting it as text, so it is very small. Pressing Control A, and then I'm going now to my StartPHP database. Here, query and paste it. Now this is done. If I go online now and refresh, as you can see, it shows the table item, and there is one item, and if I click and open it, I'm able to see it. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. What it means is the password works for the remote machine, startphp.com, and also for my local machine, startphp without .com, it is local. Thank you for watching. This was how to set up the PHPMaker with local and your hosting database username and password easily within the same interface. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it on the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And make sure to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos. Here, this is my phpMyAdmin, and I have this database called DB password, and I have one table called items. At the moment, it is empty. I've connected my phpMaker, and this is the table. Here is the item detail, and let's generate it. Select the page that you want. From here, select the location. So I've selected the location. Let's save it first. So if I generate this,